welcome to virtual class here. We are still working on Cuanta Angustia, the next part, the next maybe 20 seconds of the song. So let's start by warming up. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Remember that the weight is forward on the ball of the foot, your chest above your toes, and we're going up, down. A few times. And from here, sit down, let the knees come forward, and then go up. Sit, come up, sit, come up, sit. Now lift the heels and lower the heels. Lift the heels, lower the heels. Lift the heels, lower the heels. Come up, up, down, up, down. Again, lift the heels, lower the heels. Make sure you're not falling backwards. So the wall is here and you're just keeping the contact all the time with that wall that is your imaginary partner here. We just lifting the heels and then touching back with the heels to the floor. So now let's combine. Down, heels up, down, up, heels up, down, down, heels up, down, up, heels up, down, down, heels up, down, up, heels up, down. Very good. Now let's stretch the foot, couple of circles to the right, couple of circles to the left. Now go from right to left couple of times and go point flex couple of times. Good. And let's change the foot. Same thing, couple of circles to one side, couple of circles to the other side. Go from left to right few times and point flex few times. Good. Now we're gonna do a couple of swings with the leg because that's what we need. So we remember we stretch, pointing the toe, then we lift the leg up, then go back down, pass to the other side, same thing, point again. So just a few times. Good, change the leg, same thing on the other side, again point, the leg we lift, go down, up. Very good. Now we starting again with a little tidbit of the part that we did last week. So if you happen to practice every week, then you can dance the whole song. You can have choreography memorized to the whole song. So let's do a couple of big clappies first. So we're gonna stretch forward, then go back to neutral, stretch side, neutral, back, neutral, side, neutral, forward, neutral, side, neutral, back, neutral. Now forward, directly side, directly back, and through the center point, and again few times. Forward, side, back, forward, side, back, forward, side, back. Good. The other leg, again, forward, center, side, center, back, center, side, center, forward, center, side, center, back, center, side, center. Now forward, directly side, directly back, come back through the center, forward, side, back, forward, side, back, forward, side, back, and forward, side, back. Very good. Now let's make this more smooth, more oval and slightly smaller. So I go small ovals. And I'm using a little bit up front of me and a little bit behind me. Yes, it's pretty equal. Few times. And let's change the other side the same. Little oval starting forward. Good. Now let's imagine the line that you are standing on, and we're gonna move the same little circles up front of this line. So we only on the front of the line. Again, starting forward. Good, and then same circles but behind the line. So it's very little forward, it starts forward but it's very little, and then it's a little bigger on the back. Good, and change again on the other leg, first the forward ones, on the forward of the line, the front of the line. Good, and the same ones but behind the line. Good. Now we're gonna sort of combine both versions. So we're gonna start forward, go the big one, and when we are executing the small one behind, we're gonna turn. But let's try just this few times. So start forward, make a big one, and then the small one behind. Start forward, big one, small one together. Forward, big one, small one together. Forward, big one, small one together. Let's do the other side. Forward, big one, small one together. 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 So now let's use the help of our lapis. Let's use the impulse from that to turn. So we're gonna start the lapis, and when we are about halfway through, we're gonna turn. Yes? So back and turn, forward and turn, forward and turn, forward and turn. Let's go to the other leg and the other side. So again, about here you start turning, stretch and turn, stretch and turn, stretch and turn. Stretch and turn. Stretch and turn. Stretch and turn. Very good. So now we're gonna add this additional circle. However, when we turn, we're gonna leave the leg extended rather than coming back to the center. So I'm gonna start my turn. I'm gonna initiate the lapis. Use it for my turn and leave the leg extended. Let's do that again. Forward, initiate the turn and leave the leg stretched. Again, forward, lapis and turn. 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 The other leg, same thing. Forward, lapis and turn. Again, forward, lapis and turn. Again, forward, lapis and turn. Again, forward, lapis and turn. Very good. So let's put it back into the choreography, to the moment where we finished off last time. So we were standing about here, next to our reference point, we were taking a step back with the left leg. The right leg was going up front, and then we were passing it back. And when the leg was up, we were using this to make our little adornment and leave the leg stretch forward. After that, we collected to the cross and we were about to step forward. So let's repeat this few times. You know the movement. The only thing that changes right now, it happens in the air. So we take step back with the left, up, back, and turn, cross, forward. One more time. Step back, up, back, turn point, cross, and forward. One more time. Step back, up, back, turn, cross, cross forward. One more time. Step back, up, back, point, cross, and forward. One more time. Back, up, up, down, cross, and forward. Very good. So that is our connection point with the part from last week. Now, what's happening next? From here, we're gonna take a forward step, the one we just took right here, and we're gonna pass the other leg up front to find the comfortable point where our ball of the foot can land. So we can be like this, but eventually we're gonna land. So let's practice this. Step forward with the right and pass the leg and back. Forward, pass the leg and return. Forward, pass the leg and return. Forward, pass the leg and return. Now let's change legs. Forward, find that point and return. Forward, go around, find the point and return. Forward, pass the leg, find the point, and return. And of course, you know that already, and if you forgot, you probably cut yourself. We know that you wanna go far enough here that you can safely pass with your heel. So we wanna be close, but not too close, not to risk the cut, yes? So here, and on the other side here. Right? Okay, so that's easy, yeah? Now, from here, we're gonna attempt to turn. So, let me show you from the side. So, we're gonna go forward. We're gonna pass the leg to the other side. And we're gonna use both points of support to turn. We're gonna turn all the way back here and tiny more. So basically we're turning 360 plus 90, so that's 450 turn. Now as you see at the end, I had to change the leg. So I was turning on both legs, but then at the last quarter, I had to release the leg and commit to one leg. In this case, the left. So the movement started on the right leg. We passed the left leg around. Now we have two points of support. We use both to turn, 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 turn. 360 and quarter more. And at that last quarter, kind of smoothly and invisibly, the weight passes to, commits to one leg, left one. And we finish with the right leg free. Let's do that a couple of times very slow. So I go right leg forward, I pass the left leg, I turn around, and I have a right leg free. One more time. Right leg forward, pass the left leg, don't get too close, far enough, to safely turn. We turn about 360 and tiny bit more so the right leg is free. Now let's try a couple of times without stopping. So right leg, left leg passes, we turn to about here. So the right leg is free. One more time. Let's do four more times. So we go forward, pass the leg and around. So the right leg is free. One more time. Forward, pass the left leg, turn, and have the right leg free. And forward, pass the left leg, turn, so the right leg is free. Let's do the same exercise to the left leg. So we're going forward with the left, and we pass to the other side. We have our support, we're gonna be turning on both feet. We turn to about here and tiny bit more, committing the weight this time to the right side. So the left one is free. We are going left leg forward, let the right leg pass, find the support. We're gonna turn 360 on both legs. And at the last moment, commit to the right leg, so the left one is free. Left leg forward, pass the weight to the other side, turn and have the left leg free. One more time. Left leg forward, pass the right leg, turn around 360. And commit to the right leg, so the left one is free. One more time. Left forward, pass the right leg, find the support, turn 360, and at the end finish with the weight on the right leg, left leg free. One more time. Left, pass the right, turn, and left leg free. The next exercise that we need to do before anything else is lapis with the turn. So lapis we already practiced a million times, it's the same one, the one that starts forward and go back. But now we're gonna finish it with the back crosses. So the back crosses, we simply go from the back and cross, go from the back and cross, go from the back and cross. The only thing that we want to pay attention to, if possible, our toes together, heels apart, or pretty much flat, yeah? But it looks a little bit better if your toes are together and heels apart. And also, that gives you the nice extension when you continue with the lapis. So let's practice this way. You go forward with the lapis, you go back, you cross behind, and change weight. Lapis and change weight. Lapis and change weight. Lapis, 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 change weight. We're gonna attempt to do the same movement, but again, turn 180. So we already know that we are helping ourselves turn with that lapis. So normally we deactivate it, so the leg moves from the core and the turn is not happening. We are not creating any impulse, we're simply changing the weight behind. But this time we're gonna use this swinging action of the leg to help us turn. So again, about this moment, the turn can start happening. And again, we wanna finish with the cross behind. Let's try. So, lapis and cross. 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 Very good. So you have the lapis with the cross. The next thing we need is the turn with those back crosses. So I can continue doing these back crosses and start turning to one or the other side. In this case, we want to start turning to the right. So I initiate the cross and turn a quarter. Initiate the cross and turn. Initiate, turn. Initiate, turn. Initiate, turn. Initiate, turn. Initiate, turn. Initiate, turn. So you see, one time the leg goes the same direction as you, and the other way, the other leg is going opposite direction than you. So the leg is going to one direction and you turning to the opposite direction. So one is you going with your leg, and the other time you going against the leg, or the leg goes against you, whatever you prefer. So one with the leg and against the leg, 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 with the leg. Good. Now let's do the same thing to the other side. So now to the left is gonna be with the leg. We are turning to the left. With the leg, against the leg. With and against. 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 So let's combine the last two exercises together. We're gonna start with the right leg first. We're gonna start the lapis and then initiate the 180 turn. And then we use two crosses to turn 90-90, two quarters to complete the full 360. Ready? And lapis, 180, 90, and 90. Yes, one more time with the right leg. Lapis, cross, cross, and cross. One more time with the right leg. Lapis, cross, cross, and cross. Okay, so more or less you understand the movement to the right and with the right leg. Now let's do the same thing with the left leg. So again, first the full lapis that end up with the cross, and we're gonna use that to turn 180, and then 90 and 90. Yes, couple of times with just the left. So lapis, cross, and cross, and cross. Again, lapis, cross, and cross, and cross. Again, lapis, cross, and cross, and cross. Last time, lapis, cross, and cross, and cross. Okay, now let's mix, because right now I have right leg available, so I don't have to change. Let's do one 360 to the right and the other 360 to the left. Ready? And lapis, cross, and cross, and cross. Lapis, cross, and cross, and cross. Lapis, cross, and cross, and cross. Lapis, cross, cross, cross. Lapis, cross, cross, cross. Lapis, cross, cross, cross. Lapis, cross, 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 lapis, cross, cross, and cross. Excellent. Now, just to trick you, what happens if we start this way? Can we do the same thing? Of course, it's the same exact thing. We're gonna turn 360. We're just changing our reference point. But just in case, to prove yourself, let's do it. So let's start this way with our back to our original front. So let's start with the right. Lapis, cross, 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 lapis, cross, cross, cross. Okay, great. So let's combine these two elements with our step turn. Let's go. Step forward with the right, pass the left leg, 2 points of the support, turn, 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 360. Now we have our right leg free, which we're gonna immediately use for our lapis from exactly this position that you just practiced. So lapis, cross, cross, and cross. Very good. One more time. So step forward, left leg, turn, 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 right leg free, lapis, turn, cross, cross. So we are continuously turning to the right. One more time. And forward, cross, turn, 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 lapis, cross, cross, and cross. So let's do the same thing with the left leg. We're gonna go forward with the left, pass the leg, turn, 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 release the lapis, first cross, second cross, and third cross. One more time with the left, left forward, pass the right, turn 360, lapis, first cross, second cross, and third cross. One more time, step with the left, cross, turn, 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 release the lapis, first cross, second cross, and third cross. So now let's go back to our choreography. Step back, leg, leg, point, cross. Forward with the right, pass the left, full turn, lapis, first cross, second cross, third cross, and the left leg free. One more time, left back, up, up, point, cross, forward, pass the leg, 360, release the lapis, cross, cross, and cross, left leg free. One more time, left back, up, up, point, cross, forward, go around, 360, lapis, first cross, second cross, and third cross. One more time, left back, up, up, point, cross, forward, around, 360, lapis, first cross, second cross, third cross. So let's try with the music. If you are working with the song, then we are about 1 minute, 2 seconds to start with and get back to our decoration, our adornment with the leg.
Y quema más y más y duele más la nieve de tu carne de azucena. Cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Y quema más y más y duele más la nieve de tu carne de azucena. cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Cuánto y quema más y más y duele más la nieve de tu carne de azucena. Cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Cuando la y quema más y más y duele más la nieve de tu carne de azucena. Cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Cuando...
Okay, so let's keep adding. So we finished off with the left leg free after all that's just happened. And with this left leg, we're gonna do four boleos. Back, forward, back, forward. Now, we're gonna take the left leg back. So knee, we're aiming to go knee behind the knee, if possible, on the floor. So the foot is on the floor. On the floor. Once we have this, we're gonna get the leg up, around and down. Back, up, 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 down. Let's do the same with the other leg. Back, knee behind the knee, up and down. Back, up, 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 down. Let's switch the legs again. Back, up, down. Back, up, down. Back, up, down. Back, up, down. So you notice that I'm going back up here, but then my leg travels all the way here before it comes down. So it creates sort of a little sensation like this. Yes? A little loop, loop, back, loop, back, loop, back, loop, back, loop. Let's do to the other side. Back, loop, back, loop, back, loop, back, loop. Back, loop, back, loop. Now, let's change the leg again. So when we go back and loop back to this moment, we have knees together. We're gonna go around, kind of crossing knee in front of the knee now. And from here, we have the position as though we were sitting at the desk and have our knee, our leg on top of the other leg, right? But we're not gonna go that much down, but the tightness and the sensation is the same. And from here, the leg goes up. Now I show from the side, the leg goes up, but up behind there, not here. So if I have a partner in front and I do that, they're not gonna like it. So the leg are tight, the legs are tight here, and the foot goes up, but behind me. So we go around and up, come back, around, up, come back, around, up, come back, around, up, come back. Let's change the foot. Around, up, down, come back, around, up, come back, around, up. Come back, around, up, come back, around, up, come back. Now, let's combine. Start with the left leg working, the right one standing, and we go from the back. So back, loop, down, around, up again, and back, and forward, and back, and forward, and back, and forward, and back, and forward. Let's change. Same thing on the other leg. Back, up, around, up, around. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Change the legs again. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. One more time. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. One more time to the other side. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Now let's move you around just to confuse you a little bit. Let's do this way. Four and four. Starting with the right. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Other leg, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward. Let's turn around again this way, starting with the right. Back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward. Let's change the leg, left now, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, and forward. And the last direction, starting with the right, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, and forward. Change. Back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward. Last element. Well, not quite last, almost last. Last by one. Let's start this way, so we see what's happening. We're gonna extend left leg forward. Forward. But as we're extending the left forward, we're gonna try to find the opposition so the body can turn opposite way. So as I'm going forward, I'm thinking I'm gonna be turning to my right. So I go forward, turn. Again. Forward, turn. Again, forward, turn. Again, forward, turn. Come back, let's do to the other leg. So this time I'm going right forward, but I'm thinking I'll be turning to my left immediately after my leg reach the farthest extension. So I go, leg. Turn, come back. Again, leg. Turn, come back. Again, leg. Turn, come back. Again, leg. Turn, come back. Very good. Now, it's not gonna be that easy. We have to complicate it. So we go extend left. we turn and we bring the leg back to collect it, but with the back cross. So we went, we extend, we turn, and we collect it. Now let's go with the other leg. So we extend, we turn, and we collect it. And change weight, of course, so now you have left leg free. Extend, turn, cross behind, change weight. Extend, turn, cross behind, change weight. Extend, we always turning towards the open side, yes? So we extend, turn, cross behind, change weight. Extend, turn, cross behind, change weight. Extend, turn, cross behind. Extend, turn, cross behind. Still too easy, right? Okay, so at the very end, we're gonna add the pivot, 180 pivot, with those legs already crossed. So we go, left leg forward, turn, and I can continue turning as I'm collecting this leg. So I don't have to collect and then do the turn. I can continue turning and bring that foot in. Again, extend the left, turn, continue turning, and cross behind. Again with the left, left, turn, finish. Okay, let's try the other one. So now right leg extends, the right leg extends, we turn towards the open side, and we continue turning the same direction as we are collecting our cross. So essentially we're finishing the same way as we started. Right leg, turn, continue turning, cross behind. One more time with the right leg. Extend, turn, continue turning, and cross behind. Now let's go one with the left leg and one with the right leg. So now left leg first. Left, start turning and finish change weight. Right, start turning, finish change weight. Left, start turning, finish change weight. Right, start turning, finish change weight. Left, start turning, finish change weight. Right, start turning, finish change weight. Let's do the same thing facing this front and then facing the opposite front, because that last version will be what we are using in our choreography. So let's start this way so you can easily copy. So we go left leg forward, turn, finish the turn. Now we change weight and the right leg should be free. So again, forward, turn, and finish change weight. Forward, turn, finish change weight. Forward, turn, finish change weight. Very good. Let's go to this side. Forward, start turning, finish the turn, the right leg free. Forward, start turning, finish turn, change weight. Forward, start turning, finish, right leg free. Forward, start turning, finish, left leg free. Start turning and finish. So we're gonna finish in our choreography exactly in this position with our right leg free. So the element that we're gonna start with next time is gonna be the big lap is going all the way to the other side and finishing on the line that we are standing. So we were here, lap is not just here, it continue all the way to that line. So let's practice this few times. Big lap is. And this time we're gonna bend the knee to make the lapis huge. Big lapis. Again, from the cross, big lapis. Again, big lapis. Good. Let's practice with the other leg so it doesn't feel bad. Cross, big lapis. Again, cross, big lapis. Again, from the cross, big lapis. Again, from the cross, big lapis. Very good. So let's practice a little bit those new elements that we added. So we added four boleos, and rosca terne, and the lapis. We were finishing this way with the left leg free, and we went back, forward, back, forward, extend, start turning, finish turning, and lapis. One more time. One, two, three, four, extend, start turning, finish turning, and lapis. One more time. One, two, three, four, extend, start turning, finish turning, big lapis. One more time. One, two, three, four, extend, start turning, finish turning, and lapis. Let's go to the other leg, again, just to practice with the right leg. So, one, two, three, four, extend, start turning, finish turning, and lapis. One more time, back, front, extend, start turning, finish turning, and lapis. One more time with the right, one, two, three, four, extend, start turning, finish turning, and lapis. Ready for everything together? We go. Back, leg up, up, point, and cross. Go forward, pass the leg, turn, initiate your lapis to the cross, second cross, third cross, now boleo, 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 extend, start turning, finish turning, and lapis. Back, up, up, point, cross, forward, pass the leg, turn, 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 initiate the lapis to the first cross, second cross, third cross, boleo, one, two, three, four, stretch, and finish with the cross, and lapis. Back, up, up, point, cross, forward, pass, turn, 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 lapis to the cross, cross, and cross, and one, two, three, four, extend, start turning, finish turning, and pause.
La nieve de tu carne de azucera, cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto, es vivir queriendo tanto, cuando la vida nos deja entre los brazos un mísero retazo de compás. fuera. Cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Cuando la vida nos deja entre los brazos un mísero retazo de compasión. Y quema más y más y duele más la nieve de tu carne de azucena. Cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Cuando la vida nos deja entre los brazos un mísero retazo de compasión. Y quema más y más y duele más la nieve de tu carne de azucena. Cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Cuando la vida nos deja entre los brazos un mísero retazo de compasión.
Now, for those who are practicing religiously and remembering the whole song, we have our Señor Paul Bach. He's very handsome and elegant today, almost like Hernan. So let's dance the whole thing.
Cuántas veces por vos he llegado a mentir en el nombre de Dios. No me viste callar con un gesto feroz por temor a gritar. No te quedes un minuto más, que mi vida ya no tiene más. Pero al verte partir, con horror te abracé por temor, amor. Cuánta angustia, cuánta pena, todo duele, todo quema. Y quema más y más y duele más la nieve de tu carne de azucena. Cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Cuando la vida nos deja entre los brazos un mísero retazo de compasión. Cuántas veces por vos he llegado a mentir en el nombre de Dios. No me viste callar con un gesto feroz por temor a gritar. No te quedes un minuto más, que mi vida ya no tiene más. Pero al verte partir, con horror te abracé por temor, amor. Cuánta angustia, cuánta pena, todo duele, todo quema. Y quema más y más y duele más la nieve de tu carne de azucena. Cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Cuando la vida nos deja entre los brazos un mísero retazo de compasión. Cuántas veces por vos he llegado a mentir en el nombre de Dios. No me viste callar con un temor a gritar. No te quedes un minuto más, que mi vida ya no tiene más. Pero al verte partir, con horror te abracé por temor a morir. Cuánta angustia, cuánta pena, todo duele, todo quema. Y quema más y más y duele más la nieve de tu carne de azucena. Cuánta angustia, cuánto espanto es vivir queriendo tanto. Cuando la vida nos deja entre los brazos un mísero retazo de compás.